Welcome to the third animation tutorial and the seventh tutorial overall in the MPS tutorial series. This time, we'll look into creating an IK rig and using the IK retargeter in case you have animations of an unmatching skeleton. This tutorial is using the FPS assault pack by Deadghost Interactive and the AK animations by Obsidian Designs. To start, let's try to add the animations to the system as we have done before. Right-click on the animation, use the IK retargeter, choose the correct skeletons, and retarget. As you can see, the retargeter has mostly done a good job, however the spine rotation is messed up. You can try to manually rotate the spine and use keys to fix the offset, however this will not lead to a precise result this time. Even though the original mesh has additional bones, I believe this isn't the issue. Most likely, the spine rotation has received a slight offset in the DCC application, where the animations were created. Nonetheless, we can still make use of these animations. This allows us to get acquainted with the new IK rig and IK retargeter tools in Unreal Engine 5. Right-click in the content browser and navigate to animations and select IK rig. With this tool, you'll be defining bone chains so that the IK retargeter can make sense of the hierarchy. This is a simple and quick process. To start, we need to define the root bone. Contrary to what you would expect, the root bone is the pelvis. So right-click on the pelvis and select Set Retarget Root. Next, select the entire leg chain with the exception of the twist bones, right-click and select New Retarget Chain from selected bones. A pop-up window will come up asking you for the name. This time, the default name is fine. The next pop-up window will ask us to create goals, which we don't need, so select No Goal. Repeat this step for the twist bones individually, the right leg and the spine from spine_01 to spine_03. The clavicle should be its own chain. Watch out, Unreal wants to call the clavicle left arm, so change the name manually. The next chain will be upper arm to hand, and this will be called left arm. To speed things up, you can select all the hand bones and select New Retarget Chain from selected bones. The system is smart enough to identify the individual chains. Also create individual chains for the upper dash and lower arm twist bones. Repeat the same process for the right side. Another chain is neck to head. Create individual chains for camera FP and weapon. We don't need to create chains for the IK bones. Double check that all the chains are correct and save. Next, create an IK retargeter found under animation IK rig. Choose the new AK IK rig. Select IK MPS as the target and offset it a bit to the right, so both meshes can be well seen. Now we'll need to match the chain mappings. As you can see, some names match, others don't, so manually go through each. Set the source chain to none if there's no fitting chain. Once this process is completed, you can go to the asset browser and test the animations. If you're happy with the result, export the animation. Now we have a much better result for the upper body. There seems to be some offset with the left foot, however, this doesn't matter to us, since the lower body has its own animations. At this point, I want to show you the weapon setup. I've exported the mesh to Blender and set up an armature. Noteworthy is that this mesh has now two magazines stacked on top of each other, because the reload animations used two magazines. There are certainly different methods of tackling this issue, this is just a quick and easy solution. In Unreal, I've color-coded the second magazine for testing purposes. Now it's time to use the sequencer again. For this, create a new level and place the CR_MPS control rig in it. As before, attach a camera and the weapon mesh to the character. Load the desired animation into the sequencer. And we're presented with a problem since the weapon isn't in the hands. Open the animation and manually drag the weapon bone into the correct position as we have done with the bat before. Once happy with the position, create a key. These changes then directly apply to the sequencer. Let's check out what we have so far in first-person view. The camera is quite offset and is moving too much, which would be nauseating in-game. Thankfully, this can be quickly fixed. Bake the animation to the CR_MPS control rig. Select the camera FP bone and remove all its keys on the timeline. Zero out the rotation in the Anim Details tab. Now the camera is perfectly facing forward and isn't affected by the head's rotation. To finish the idle animation, create an additive layer. We want to move the weapon a bit further upwards so that it's better visible in the first-person view. There are two ways of doing this. You can either select the left hand, right hand and weapon bone and move them all up and create a key in the additive layer, or you can use constraints and only move the right hand. To do so, select the left hand bone and press the plus icon on the constraints tab and select parent. Now you need to choose the parent in the 3D viewport. You can either select the control rig right hand or the actual right hand bone of the mesh. Technically both is possible, however, in my testing I've gotten better results using the actual mesh bone. Repeat this process for the weapon bone. If you still encounter errors, a simple solution can be to create a key first and then constraint the bone. Lastly, we need to remove the keys on the base layer track of the constrained bones to remove any unwanted movements. Now we can simply select the right hand bone and the weapon and left hand will follow automatically. Export the animation. To further iterate on the constraint tool, we'll briefly cover the reload animation, since we'll need to also constrain the magazine to the left hand. As before, retarget the animation, key the weapon bone to the correct location by simply copying the layer track data and load it into the sequencer. Again, remove all the camera keys and zero out the camera rotation. This time, only constrain the weapon bone to the right hand bone and remove all its keys from the base layer. The left hand is moving on its own, so a constraint is pointless here. Move the right hand and left hand up to better visualize the weapon in the first-person view. Create a control rig for the weapon. Scroll through the timeline until you find the pose, where the magazine is about to be removed from the weapon. create a parent constraint to the left hand. Now find the point in time where the magazine is fixed to the weapon again. Click the little plus icon next to the left-hand constraint inside the animation tab. This ends the constraint. As you can see, the rotation and position are off. To fix this, we'll need to manually alter the left-hand position. Make sure you copy the key for the base pose of the left hand and paste it to the point in time, where the left hand grips the handguard again to nullify the changes again. This can be taken even further by attaching the magazine to the pelvis when a new magazine is taken from the rig and throwing the old one into the world. This is where your artistic side comes into play. In this part, I'll show you all the animations I had modified in the sequencer. You can even combine animations as shown with the draw animation. There's a quick draw and a first draw, which additionally handles the safety rotation. The aiming animations needed to be created anew, since the anim pack didn't come with real ADS anims. Lazily, I've used the base idle animation and simply moved the weapon in front of the camera using the additive layer. I've divided this into three parts: aim in, aim idle, and aim out, all in one timeline. I've simply trimmed the timeline to only export the desired sections. Here's an overview of the folder structure containing all the source animations and sequencer files. The weapon animations. The poses created with the ADS tool and the final body animations. Lastly, I've imported some generic AK sounds and created its own cues. The reload cues were added to the weapon montages using sound notifies. The shoot sound was added to the DT underscore weapon data table. Last but not least, to make the weapon animations and sounds work, we need to create an animation blueprint for the weapon. Simply right-click the weapon skeleton and create an animation blueprint. This can be kept very basic. All we need is to set the default slot in the animation graph. Link up the reference in the event graph by creating a cast with a new actor variable. This could be expanded upon like I did with the SMG. It has moving parts for walking and sprinting, as well as a rotating fire selector. This concludes the animation tutorial subseries. You have learned how to use the control rig and sequencer to adjust existing animations to fit the weapon proportions. You have learned how to use the simple retargeting method and key tracks feature to add matching animations to the system. And finally, you have learned how to create an IK rig and IK retargeter to add entirely new animations to the system. You can now fine-tune animations using additive layers and constraints. The next tutorial will cover how to add new attachments. Thanks for watching.